Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me today. Let's get into our hello song, and then we're going to talk about what we're going to do today. So let's go. Hello, everybody. I'm so glad to see you. 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 Hi, everybody. So this week we are going to be learning about weather and nature and the phases of the moon and all the fun things that happen out in the earth and the world, right? So to go along with that, we're going to sing a song called Oh, Mr. Sun, because I love the sun and we need more sun, right? We need more sun. So let's call the sun to us. Ready? So let's get into it, right? Oh, Mr. Sun, sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me. Oh, Mr. Sun, sun, Mr. Golden Sun, hiding behind a tree. These little children are asking you to please come out so we can play with you. Oh, Mr. Sun, sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me. Oh, Mr. Sun, sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me. Oh, Mr. Sun, sun, Mr. Golden Sun, hiding behind a tree. These little children are asking you to please come out so we can play with you. Oh, Mr. Sun, sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me. All right, so now we are going to go into our book of the day. So I'm going to share my screen and I'm going to put up the book that we're going to read today, which is called Up in the Garden and Down in the Dirt by Kate Messner, with art by Christopher Silas Neal. Up in the garden, I stand and plan, my hands full of seeds and my head full of dreams. Spring sun shines down to melt the sleepy snow. Wind whistles through last year's plants and mud sucks at my rain boots. It's not quite time, Nana says. Down in the dirt, things need to dry out and warm up. What's down there, I ask. Down in the dirt is a whole busy world of earthworms and insects digging and building and stirring up soil. They're already working down in the dirt. Up in the garden, we snap brittle stalks, scoop rusty armfuls, and wheel away weeds for the chickens. While they squabble and scratch, we spread compost over the soil. Down in the dirt, pill bugs chew through last year's leaves. I give a gentle poke and they roll up tight and hide in pleated suits of armor, roly-poly round. Up in the garden, it's time to plant. I trail a furrow with my finger and sprinkle seeds in careful row. Give them a drink, Nana says. We pat them down to snuggle in the dark. Down in the dirt, a tomato hornworm rests, waiting for wings and the leaves where she lay her eggs. Up in the garden, carrot plants sprout, pea blossoms bloom, and wasps are on the prowl. Honeybees visit, legs loaded with pollen. I weed and wilt in the sun so strong even Nana looks for shade. Down in the dirt, the earthworms tunnel deep. I'm jealous of their cool, damp, dark. Up in the garden, a rain shower. Nana turns the hose on me. Eee! I hide behind the cucumber vines, but their leaves can't save me. I shiver and laugh, drenched in Nana's rain. Down in the dirt, the water soaks deep. Roots drink it in, and the long-legged spider still walks over the streams. Up in the garden, there's so much to eat. Ladybugs feast on aphids. Nana crunches green beans and I bite a ripe tomato warm from the sun and the juice dribbles down my chin. Down in the dirt, a robin's beak finds a cricket, a beetle, and grub. Slugs are scrumptious too. Mm. Up in the garden, we pick cucumbers and zucchini, harvesting into the dark. Bats swoop through the sunflowers, and I pluck the June bugs from the basil until it's time for bed. Down in the dirt, skunks work the night shift. They snuffle and dig and gobble cutworms while I sleep. Up in the garden, a praying mantis wakes to hunt mosquitoes. Nana sprays away the aphids, and I'm after grasshoppers, ready to swoosh, but snap! Someone else finds is faster. Down in the dirt, a smooth, shining garter snake crunches on supper. Up in the garden, the wind grows cool, and pumpkins blush orange, and sunflowers bow to September. Nana ties them together to build a house for reading. Down in the dirt, an orb weaver spins her web, strand by silken strand. She'll munch on the moths tonight. Up in the garden, colored leaves litter the squash vines, and we know the cold is coming. Hurry, hurry, and harvest. There's enough for the neighbors, too. Down in the dirt, frantic ants gather what we leave behind. They're storing food for cooler days ahead. Up in the garden, frost draws lace on leftover leaves where secret egg sacs hang, waiting for the warm to return. We say goodbye and spread the winter blankets. Down in the dirt, the beetles burrow, ants scurry home, and earthworms curl tight in the dark. When Grandpa calls us in for soup, an autumn moon is rising. Up in the garden, dry corn stalks tremble and the wind smells like winter. But the long ripe days of summer still rest in the garden beds. The ladybugs and bumblebees, earthworms and ants are hunkered down, hiding, biding their time. Dreaming of sunshine and blossoms and sprouts, under the bare arms of trees and the blanketing snow, a whole new garden sleeps down in the dirt. The end. So that is a great story, guys, about the nature and how it works with, you know, gardening and how the insects and the bugs help to promote the garden and the soil and how things change with the seasons, right? So many fun things from that book that we learned. So now we're going to do a felt board activity. And I'll get it out for us to read, to listen to. One little raindrop in the dark, dark sky. Two little raindrops watch the clouds roll by. Three little raindrops go splat, splat, splat. Four little raindrops say, "We'll need boots for that." And five little raindrops, "And still no sun? That's too much for us. We better. Five little raindrops. All right. So let's read a song. Let's sing a song about nature. So I'm going to do a song called Teddy Bear, Teddy Bear. And this one we actually have to stand up for. So I'm going to stand up. Move my camera around so you can see me. Okay, ready? Raindrop, raindrop, turn around. Raindrop, raindrop, touch the ground. Raindrop, raindrop, touch your nose. Raindrop, raindrop, touch your toes. Raindrop, raindrop, hop, hop, hop. Raindrop, raindrop, drop, drop, drop. Raindrop, raindrop, here's the sun. Raindrop, raindrop, run, run, run. Raindrop, raindrop, sit nearby. Raindrop, raindrop, wave goodbye. So that's a good song about the rain. And Let us close. Let us do our...
Oh, no. Sorry, guys.
Sorry. Dropped my phone.
And my lighting. So I apologize. Whoopsies.
Fixed. Okay. Sorry about that. Now we are going to do our language activity. So let me get it up on the screen. Today we were learning about the phases of the moon. So we're going to share. Play from the start. Okay, and we're going to learn about the phases of the moon today. So this is called a new moon. Now, what's really important about the moon is that what we see is all from how the sun and the earth and the moon are all aligned in its orbit, right? So the sun and the moon orbit around the earth and the moon orbit around the sun, and therefore it's when we orbit, which means to go around, right? When we go around the sun, we see the moon in different light, right? Parts of the moon are in shadow and parts of the moon are in light. So when there's a new moon, that means that the sun and the moon and the earth are all lined up, and you can, and the whole moon is in its shadow and the sun is behind it. So we see the sun behind it. I'll show you. The sun is shining behind it, and all we can see is the moon's shadow. So that's what we see when we see a new moon, right? Next is a crescent moon. And the crescent moon can be on this side or it can be on this side. And basically, it's just part of the moon that we can see because the sunlight is hitting it. And the rest of the moon is all in shadow. So what we see is called the crescent moon. Crescent moon. And it could be on this side or it can be on this side, depending upon where the Earth is positioned or in its orbit. This is a quarter moon. So a quarter moon, you can see half the moon and the other half of the moon is in shadow, right? So this half of the moon is in shadow and this half of the moon is in the light. So that's a quarter moon. And then this is a gibbous moon. A gibbous moon, you can see almost all the moon, okay? Most of the moon is in the light and only a tiny bit is in the shadow, right? So that's called a gibbous moon. Gibbous moon. And again, it depends on what part, where we are in the Earth's orbit. It's dependent upon which side we see the moon, right? We see this side of the moon, or we can have the gibbous moon on the other side. And then this is a full moon. So a full moon means that the sun is fully shining and we can see the moon to its fullest, right? We see all the parts of the moon. None of it is in shadow, right? So that is called a full moon. So those are the phases of the moon. So I'm gonna stop sharing my screen and I'm going to, hold on. Stop sharing my screen. Thank you. Okay. And we're going to sing one song together. So I'm going to put it on. Hold on.
Five, four, three, two, one. Blast off. Another rocket ship. Five, four, three, two, one. Rocket ship run, take me to the sun. take me to the sun. When I get there, I'll be spinning through the air, spinning around the sun. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off, another rocket ship run. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off, another rocket ship run. Take me to the moon. Take me to the moon. When I get there, I'll be dancing through the air, dancing on the moon.
Everybody. All right. So thank you guys for joining me today. I hope you had a wonderful time and I will see you all tomorrow. Bye guys.